And good evening. All right, we're gonna rock it up tonight. No routine, no deal.
Billy Ray was a preacher's son, and when his daddy would visit, he'd come alone.
I'm trying to experiment.
When they got around and started talking, that's when Billy
Ray
would
keep walking.
I threw the light down, we go walking. Then he looked into my eyes. Lord knows to my surprise, the only one that ever touched me was the son of a preacher man, the only boy who could ever teach me was the son of a preacher man. Yes, he was. He was. Yes, he was. Being good isn't always easy, no matter how hard I try. When he started sweet talking to me, he'd come and tell me everything is alright. He kissed me on it, everything's alright. Can I get away again tonight? The only one who could ever reach me was the son of a preacher man. The only boy who could ever teach me was the son of a preacher man. Yes, he was. He was. How will I remember the
All right, let's discuss sexual brainwashing and what it means. Now I can go into some super detail because I was part of it. No, I didn't create it. I didn't invent the idea. I just helped implement it. And sometimes I say to myself, why did I quit? It paid well, unlimited women, unlimited beautiful hotel rooms, you name it. Well, I regret every moment of it. Not the women so much, but I did not think we'd get this far, and it was all planned years ago in the 50s. I was just trying to stop from 1979 for 9 years, if that, I can't do the math. But I know what it is when I see it, and I see it everywhere. For example, I go onto YouTube, and I go to look up anything. Doesn't matter. What do I see? How to get quick abs. How to get instant abs. Do abs really attract women? And do guys actually believe abdominal muscles attract women? It's part of the sexual brainwashing. And how does that work? It makes you feel totally inadequate because you don't have abs like that emaciated guy in the picture. And they work on women too. I am waiting for one woman, Gary Brodsky, 123 at AOL.com. Tell me, I don't think I'm fat. No, they all think they're fat. Every guy thinks they're out of shape. Every guy is doing more and more cardio. Why? Because they believe you get abs. And when you get abs, you get women. Bullshit, okay? Bullshit. Here's another one. And this one's a beauty. This was going on for years. Years ago, actually, people didn't believe this. People wanted money to buy stuff. That's the whole idea of money, is to buy things, right? No. I've heard guys say to me, well, I'd like to get women, but first I got to make the money. Okay, sounds reasonable. Think about this. The amount of birth rate in low income is 20 times the birth rate in high income. So obviously that one is not true either. So let's take this a step further. And I know you guys like this. What is the biggest, and I'm going to let you guys answer this because I know the answer. I'm not going to leave you hanging. Don't worry about it. But what is the biggest turnoff to women? And it's not a stomach, believe it or not. I have a stomach, but I'm working on it. I got my sodas here. I got my Three Musketeers bars here. I'm set up for business. I want to get a stomach. Now I got to get new pants. I can't go for that right now. So what is the biggest turnoff to women? Does anybody know? Does anybody care? And I'm waiting for you to answer that at Gary Brodsky 123 at AOL.com. just text me, because I don't even know how to text, but you guys do, because I'm learning how. And I'm going to hit a quick song, and you tell me what the biggest turn off to women is. And it's not height. I'll give you some hints. It's not weight. It's not how you look. It's not how much money you have. And it certainly ain't your abs. So let's see if you can hit me up here at GaryBrodsky123AOL.com. And let me know what the biggest turn off to women is. Well, I enjoy a cigarette. Like this casual look tonight. Yeah. I'm waiting. Oh, I am waiting. I'm not gonna wait that long, okay? I don't hear from you, I'm gonna just tell you. Sergey, how are you? Okay. Sorry, we're stopping the music. That's a good one. It's actually on top of the list. But everybody's guessing, and you're all getting good points here. Doing all what she wants and not having the identity turns off women. That's absolutely true. But that's not the big answer. Jason? The guy who plays computer games. True. But it all leads to one thing, and that's it. The voice and the pitch in the voice. That is the biggest turnoff to women. Because they're always imitating their husbands or boyfriends. And it's not like this guy walks in and goes, hey, come here, bring me a beer. You're not going to hear that. I don't hear that. It's like the guy comes in, ding, 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 just like the annoying orange. It really annoys the crap out of you if you have an effeminate voice. Fact of life. So nobody's putting ads up for voice. Hey, learn to speak now. But what causes a deeper voice, an attractive voice, is testosterone. And guys, from those last two comments, have given up on testosterone. Why? Because computer games are more fun. Internet pornography is more fun. Is it? No, it isn't. It is a big destroyer. Why? Because you're getting satisfaction without the reality. You're playing battle without consequences. You are playing games without feeling the reality. So yeah, it's not surprising that people are going insane from this. Antisocial, locked up, just the way the New World Order wants you. Stuck in fantasy land. And reality does have its price. It stings like a bastard. I'll admit that. But I'll take stinging hard reality, and I have taken tons of it, to take the brainwashing that they want you to have. And that is a fact of life. Because when it comes to reality, it's just amazing that guys have become afraid of women. It was a perfect union. That was supposed to be the way it's always been. Men with women, romance stories, all ended 20 years ago. Now all you have is, do you think I'm getting fat? I got to work on my abs. With that voice, I got to work on my abs. You can work on anything you want. Keep that voice. You know what you're going to work on? This. Unbelievable. What they will sell and people will buy. And that's a problem I have with comedians today. And have you noticed this? Every comedian, doesn't matter who they are, you want work as a comedian? I'll have you play the funniest guy there is. I'll never work as a comedian. You know why? Because every comedian now, and you can watch any show, they're all up on YouTube. What do? They all knock religion. Like the dumbest things are people who actually read the Bible. And every comedian does that. And it has an effect. What you hear, you will become. That's why we got braintrain.com. If anybody's smart enough to use it, it's everything on sale right now. As well as everything on sale at GaryBrodsky.com right now. And I have a question right now. And that is so true, Alex. Desperate, horny guys are a big turnoff to women. You know, desperate, horny guys don't even go out there anymore looking for women. It's like, you know, they're not horny guys. They're horny boys. They act like boys. They don't act like men. You know, the guys say to the woman, hey, I'll protect you. Don't worry about it. I'll take care of it. Guys don't do that. It's like, oh, this is a problem. I better run away. You know, I've heard guys say this. You know, it's like, I go to go, hey, wait a second. Are you threatening me? I have my cell phone here. I'm calling 911. Call 912 for all I care. But that's what guys become. Oh, really? Uh-huh. Are you threatening me? I'm threatening you. I just said, can you wait 1 second? That's a threat. That's a threat. But that's what guys have become. And guys wonder, what happened to women? You happened to women, okay? I'm not talking about the guys who watch the show. You know what I'm talking about. You've seen those guys. But that's, and women laugh their ass off at these guys. Because women get this too now from guys. Guys are supposed to be men. Like, hey, I'm in your corner. I'll back you up. No. It's like, oh, you said that? Are you threatening me? I have lawyers. That is what men have become today. And it's going to get worse. It doesn't go away by itself. Now, you may be asking, how do we change this? Simple. Don't act like that. It's contagious. Just as negativity is contagious, so is that. And you see it. You know, it's kind of the point where, you know, there's very few people I even want to talk to. I'm not talking about you guys who call me up anytime if I'm not busy. Because I'm busy. I only have one phone here. When I walk out of here, I have no phones. A little freedom is a good thing. But, you know, when I go to a store and I'm talking to a guy, and I go, this doesn't fit. Are you threatening me? No, I'm telling you the size doesn't fit. But I don't like your tone of voice. I don't like yours. You threatening me? Oh, forget it. You show alpha behavior, women are going to love you. Guys will fear you. We're going to have a special webinar on that. And you know what's scary? People don't even show up for that anymore. People are just giving up. I have my computer game here, my baby oil here. They're set. They are set for life. What's also killing this country and this world is, I'm one of the people that does not blame the government. I don't like a lot of their policies, but there is no ambition. There is no ambition. They can't give you that. Ambition, I had a show with somebody a while back, many years ago, and we were making a lot of money together. And he told me, I can't do the show anymore. I said, why? You're getting paid like, you know, a lot of money for 4 to 5 hours a week, or a month. And he goes to me, well, my girlfriend doesn't like it. And since then, I have not been the same. I have not been the same. I don't know what happened to him, because he can't talk because his girlfriend doesn't like it. Gary, Jason again. I watched the old Lawrence Welk show. It reminds me how men and women used to be and how people act so feminized with that same gay whiny voice that women hate. Thanks, Jason. To add to that, you know, it's really funny, but women who are watching the show, and they do this, don't like texting all the time after the show, bang, phone calls or whatever. But women can get so much more by acting like a woman. Think about it. Women go, I don't get equal pay. Yes, you do. Sorry. But if women got paid less than men, every company on earth would hire women. It's just business. It's not personal, Sonny. Sorry. But now this whole feminist movement, what is it about? Women's rights. Only 1%, check it out, of women working actually make enough money to support themselves. They didn't enter the workforce. They get to wear a suit, carry a briefcase, and give up the greatest job as dictated by God. Motherhood. Being a parent. That's not important. Not anymore. What's important is having a business card. Say, I have a high-powered job. I can have a power lunch. What the hell's a power lunch? The only thing benefiting is a goddamn restaurant. I'm taking a break. Get some questions. Gary Brodsky, 123 at AOL.com.
When the truth is found to be lies, know the joy within you. You want somebody to love? Don't you need somebody to love? Don't you love somebody to love? You will find somebody to love.
we're going to work a lot on this tonight. But good. What do you do if a woman tries to diss you in front of the girl you like? Okay, a little bit more specific. But let me just tell you this. Women will try to diss you anywhere. It's just a test. It is only a test. React, you lose the test. I don't know exactly what the situation is, but I can tell you this. As soon as you start reacting, and watch this, because I've done it myself. I'm no saint. I'm as bad as, you know, a lot of things I talk about. Some woman gives me shit, and I start going, well, what? Oh, shit, I need to catch myself. My voice is becoming feminized. I'm starting to argue like a bitch. I'm going to be treated like a bitch. Don't argue. Don't care. Very important. Hey, Joel, how are you? Hey, Gary, how are you? I'm doing great. Thank you. You've mentioned in the past being too handsome can be a disadvantage for women. Please explain this. I've seen your picture, Joel. You don't have a problem. Just kidding. What ways, what are some ways to capitalize on having good looks as a man? Okay, good looks are a disadvantage. Not because women go, oh, this guy's good looking. I don't want to go out with him. But a lot of women are insecure. This is a fact. So are men. It's okay. We covered both genders. A lot of good-looking guys have grown up knowing they're good-looking and have put no effort into their personality, character, or attitude. And when they were a kid, they got a cookie in the bakery, oh, he's so cute, he has this. And they grow up clueless. So good looks are not really an asset or liability. They just are. But women are not attracted to looks. Remember this. What looks are to men, you say, wow, she's hot. Confidence is to women. And all the confidence stuff is for sale at GaryBrodsky.com. I have to keep repeating that because I need some business. Yeah, all right. No. But it's worth saving for later. Okay. But back to the brainwashing. It's the right clothes. No. It's the right this. No, it's right. It's the right attitude, the right look. Because right now, women are almost afraid of men. Men are afraid of women. They got you down to a science. They programmed you, and you all fell for it. It's not funny. Okay, it really is not. Let me show you an average date, because I'm going to date right here. This is a simulation course. But this is the average date. Well, what do I got to tell now? I just had diarrhea sent. And texting back and forth, and everybody sees it. You know, you just want to see everybody texting? Walk outside, go anywhere. Go to any cafe now. Nobody's talking. Because people are attention junkies. Men, women, children, even animals. And if you keep getting texts all day, you lose interest in anything else. I'm getting all the attention I need. I'm getting texted. Isn't that great? Until an alpha guy comes along and says, hey, you look great. Boom. Screw texting. She's with you. But most guys are afraid to take that step and go, hey, how you doing? You look great. She's going to go like this. Big deal. What? And I know guys' lives have been ruined because of that. It's like, I asked the girl out for a date. She said, no, I haven't dated since. How long ago was that? 8 years. What? She said, that's no big deal. Yeah, she wasn't interested. So what? That means I suck. No, it doesn't mean you suck. It means big deal is what it means. Incredible. You know, what's incredible is no more hula houses. Why? Because organized crime doesn't want to set them up and make a profit? No, because nobody shows up. That's how bad things have gotten. It's now become just a game for the elite. Just for the super wealthy to have fun. And I got a question. Let me check this question out. What happened to the occult channel? It's up and running and will probably be on this week. I'm adding a few new products to the occult site. One of them is this. And if you're interested, email me at GaryBrodsky123@AOL.com. We will do the writing for you. The blue pen, white paper. Everybody knows it, and everybody knows it works, because anybody who's tried it has told me, but a lot of people just forget to do it. which is okay. If we do it for you, we will not miss a day, and we'll put in anything, you know, basically love, health, joy, happiness, prosperity, you name it, and write it for you every day. And it happens. It doesn't matter, because it's a universal unconsciousness or subconsciousness, or consciousness, actually, that's the right word. Screwing this up again. And that will absorb it. And my phone got stuck, but it's okay now. Gary, why is it that when you go into the gym, those same gay whiny guys complain you lift free weights and do not do cardio? How do we battle this? Thanks, Jason. Jason, it's happened to me. It happened to me yesterday. All guys were talking about was cardio. I was at some lunch party. And it's like, how much cardio do you do? How much cardio do you do? And it's like, I don't do any cardio. Like, so you have big muscles. What purpose do they serve? It's like, what purpose do cardio serve? There is no such thing as cardio. Real cardio is real running outside. Muhammad Ali didn't have any cardio. Babe Ruth didn't do any cardio. Any of the real Bruce Lee cardio on the machine, you see like that, doesn't happen. But that has become an obsession. Lift the free weights. You know, there's two ways to look at it. I walk in the gym, and guys are actually waiting like this for the cardio machine. The free weight section, totally empty. The only problem I have with that now, because I've given up, is that I cannot find a spot in the gym, so I got like, yeah, wait for my friends. What time are you free? I don't know. I got to work out at 3 in the morning because it's a private gym. Because I need somebody to spot me on bench, because the cardio guys won't. This is what men have become. I say, hey, can you spot me on bench press? Oh my God, no, I'm not insured. He said, hey, you need a spot? Yeah, you can ask me. Yeah, move on. Not anymore. Men have changed. No, not really. They've changed men, and you fell for it. How do you stop? GaryRoth.com has all the answers. Oh, I like the title of this one, Candles and Whores. If I light 5 or 10 candles on the same color at once, will they greatly enhance the effect of the energy? Yes. I have also found that a few hua houses that still provide great service, they still exist, just hard to find. Joel, thank you. I don't need that information. I need the addresses, okay? All right, I'll take care of this. John, how you doing? My old pal, John. Gary, it's amazing. When so many guys say they strike out with women, saying the lady was difficult, and you find out as you approach the charm and charm her. Sorry, I'm just not wearing my glasses. She eases into you, giving you more than you ever wanted to enjoy. Even married women are tickled by alpha males. Labeling women is a beta male defect. Don't do it. He's absolutely right. Don't do it. And you can have the greatest time of your life in a matter of seconds beyond minutes. That is some great wisdom, man. That is absolutely true. You know, because I've seen this with beta men. And there are a lot out there. I sometimes play a joke on them, just test them. Yeah, I know a great hula house, which I don't anymore, but they don't know that. And so I watch the show, go, hi, hi. I go, I'm treating everybody, let's go, great hula houses. And they go, I'm not into it. Oh, hey, I got a really hot girl to set you up with. How about tomorrow night? No, she's not. How does she look? She's beautiful, she's blonde, she's from Switzerland, and she does modeling magazines. Not my type. Any excuse not to get laid, which is why we have a replacement rate that is falling every day. Nobody's getting pregnant anymore. Fertility clinics, why? Guys don't have testosterone. I don't have a chair that works well. The testosterone part I address first, the chair later. And guys don't want to build testosterone. Guys don't want to be guys. It's easier to be a little kid and play your video games and watch your internet porn, which is the biggest destroyer of men. I'm anti-porn. Why? Again, you're having the situation getting stimulated without the reality. You know, it's like the martial arts schools of today. I learned from the real guys. You need 2 teeth here, tooth here. I don't know how my bottom tooth got knocked out. But I learned the guys who hit hard. And well, my Sifu Chow, most people, he doesn't have a class. He'll have friends he'll teach because he can't have a class. Why? He makes contact. And now if you want to have a class, it's got to be pretend martial arts. Pretend martial arts. Making the fake moves. Yeah, the moves actually are not bad. But without the application or really in a real situation, it's not going to work. So you have the illusion that you can fight until you get your ass kicked. That's why if you take some of the wealthiest guys, put them in suits, and take some guys from bike clubs and put them out there, the guys from bike clubs are going to score. Why? They're not insecure about the image. They're not insecure about their weight. They don't care about abs. They have attitude, and that wins all the time. And you can get it right now at GaryBrodsky.com because you need it. I need it. I do this stuff every day myself. Does playing hard to get with a woman work? Okay, playing hard to get has so many variables. But playing this, okay, is a great way to play hard to get. You know, if you're not interested, I don't care. Or I'll walk. Same women want you. It's just like, you know, it's like, hey, do you want this soda? No, I don't know. Well, okay, so, oh, wait, don't take it away. Once women know they have you, it's like, this is a mess for a lot of guys. So, Alex, thank you for the question. This is a problem guys have with women. It's like, well, she's this, she's doing that, she's doing this to me. You know why? Because she knows that if she calls you, you'll come running back. If she's not sure if she calls you, if you'll be there again, or even take a call, you're going to see a whole world of difference. It's like, yeah, I think you have to get great, I think you're wonderful, I'd really like to sleep with you, but like, if not, I don't really give a shit. When you have that attitude, that wins. Because, you know, again, as I was saying, guys, saying earlier, when you look a little too desperate, they think, okay, what's wrong with you? What is wrong with you? So you got to sort of have a little bit of like, I'm easy to get, but I easily walk away from this deal. And Donald Trump said something intelligent, and I haven't liked Donald Trump. And a funny story about him, but I don't know if I'll tell it because I don't feel like going through the same hassle. The guy's got power, he's got money. And I like what he said. He said, never enter into a business deal or negotiation to something you are not willing to walk away from. And then people say, well, look at Donald Trump. The Japanese, which is a fact, own 95% of his business. Big deal. He can buy whatever the hell he wants. But that is some great advice from Donald Trump. I know people make fun of him because of his haircut. You know, I had one last week, I had it corrected. It would have been worse than his. If you're walking into a woman with a woman, you're making a deal. This is an exchange. It's not a business deal. Unless, you know, it's a, never mind, some stupid joke here. Sitting in court again for my jokes. I'm the only one that goes to court for jokes, okay? But you got to walk in with this intention. Like, you know, if this doesn't work out, I am not here with any caring because I can walk out of this deal anytime I want. And that's a big piece of advice for every guy and for women as well. If it's not working out, close the deal. Hey, have a nice night. Good night. And by the way, it always ended nicely. Thank you for a pleasant evening. That hits a lot harder. And oh, fuck yeah, yeah. Don't act like a girl. Okay, wow. This is right in my area. We gotta go. This is great. We'll keep this quiet between us. But this is gonna happen. And it's gonna happen sooner than you think. All right, time to take a quick break. I'm gonna lose some of the songs here. So something to change the mood a little bit. love that song. Theme from Clockwork Orange, if anybody's interested. So if anybody isn't, you know, I don't want to get 20 emails. What was that theme? Theme from Clockwork Orange. It's called the March of the Queen's Funeral. I like classical music because it makes you smarter. I like classical books. I like classical literature. I'm considered like, you know, what the hell's wrong with this guy? What do you guys read today? They don't. Men don't read anymore. Look at what's in college now. It's 78% women. And I'm saying it's because women are this, women are that. No, it's because guys stop reading. That's why. It's going to be 100% women. We are going to be the most pussy society. Pick up a goddamn book and read it. And I'm serious. Oh, okay, definitely. Private question. But that is absolutely true. More women in schools today, more women earning money than men. Why? Men have given up. No ambition, no drive, no DHEA. Get it now. I am back in business. The Modern Alpha is mine. For those of you who care, and for those of you who don't care, it's still mine. And it's right at GaryBrodsky.com supplements. DHEA, and I'm going to take some right now, will build testosterone up. And you need it. Your body needs testosterone. That's what makes a man a man. And I'm going to take some right now. Got our own brand. Pure DHEA, and it works. I know I occasionally skip a day, and then I feel it. I feel it. And I'll tell you something interesting. I skipped a week intentionally, and women didn't react to me quite as well. I got the skills, I reacted, but it wasn't as smooth. Why? No DHEA, no testosterone, no attraction. Science. MK17 works. Science. And you all got emails about it tonight. And that I can't discount because my margin is very, very small on that. So I'm going to take my DHEA now before I forget. I was in some of the seminars of Manly P. Hall on YouTube. Very wise man. I don't know who he is, but I will definitely listen to him. Thank you. There are some good guys out there, but they don't get the money, the backing, or the funding because that is not the message they want out there. I'll give you another example of sexual brainwashing. This is a great one. You ever notice all the women newscasts are really hot? They all look the same. They have those bedroom eyes, seductive look. Yeah. They're teaching you because, oh, she's so hot, I'm going to believe every word she says. And guys will go out and repeat the news as it is told to you. Let me tell you something, the mainstream news is the biggest bunch of bullshit you'll ever hear. And how can I prove this? Watch your TV carefully. You will notice it says news entertainment. They don't know the weather. They don't even know, you know, they don't even have a window in their office. It's not called the weather, it's called predictions. The psychic weather hotline. Commentary. Oh, the Alpha Power Plus, yes, it frees the DHEA up. It's the same thing, and you know, thank God we are stocked full of everything right now. We just had a mass re-up on everything. And people buy this stuff so fast, if you don't order it, you may have to wait an extra couple of weeks. But we are, literally, our shelves are full of everything. By the end of next week, probably not. The greatest gift you can get for Christmas is something for yourself. Or something for me. Just for the girls watching that. But yeah, guys are afraid of testosterone. And this is my best DHEA experiment. There was some guy who was gay. From the gay community. I got to be politically correct. That is total fruit, okay? He started taking DHEA, started feeling more aggressive. He's not gay anymore. Hey, check that one out. I can't even figure that one out. But yeah, it just keeps continuing. They've got everybody in prison behind their own computer. Fantasy does not replace reality. Usually I would like my dreams to come true. Now so I want my dreams to stay my dreams because I don't want to deal with reality, the headaches, the heartaches. And yeah, dating women can be ball breakers. They break balls a lot. That is a fact. And so, oh, it drives me nuts. It drives any guy nuts. You can't show it. He's silly. Oh man, she's driving me crazy. Same fight all the time. You wake up in the morning, hey, how you doing? Good morning. You suck. What? What did I do? I don't want to, oh, what did you do? It's all about you. I know the routine. And every language and every accent, I've heard it. It's funny in Chinese. You suck. You're no good. You asshole. You bad. I've gotten that too. And it's always the same thing. And if you subscribe to it and jump into it, it's going to last forever. Cut. Can you keep your mouth silent? Good. You win. Don't talk. When that stuff starts, and this, and that shirt is no good on you, and I'll tell you what, you should die wearing that shirt. Yeah, they'll say the meanest things. Take them seriously? You're dead. So, give it a few days, it'll pass. It's a hormonal cycle. I'm trying to look for some cool stuff to show you. And I forgot where I put all my cool stuff. Nope. Well, yeah. This is not the usual knife. But anyway, any of our audio programs or supplements don't get you laid within 30 days, we'll send you your money back. Plus, yep, the knife to cut it off with. It's not the usual knife. I don't know what the usual knife is. Ah, it's right here. Okay. If any of our products don't work, or you don't get laid, satisfied, and have women coming all over you, we will send you the real knife to cut it off with. I thought this went out in the mail to some guy who was having problems, but he overcame them. Now just think about this. We have an audio program called the Pimp Mindset. And a lot of guys go, well, I'm too classy for the Pimp Mindset. So wait one second. I'm way too classy for the Pimp Mindset. Now the Pimp Mindset is about this. Okay, pimp can get 50 girls to go out and suck 1,000 dicks a night and give him all the money. Why? They gotta push the right buttons. You have this knowledge, you're gonna win. Okay? And it's on sale right now. Hey Gary, I take my DHA and alpha Boomai every day. I feel great. It makes you feel alive on top of the world. Go buy it now and you'll thank me for it. Thanks, Jason. Well, I'm thanking you right now, Jason, because I just took it and I'm already feeling better. You know, I just don't want to go out and lift weights, you know, lay anything in sight, chop down a tree. I'll tell you something about the Palohead and Bimmy ones, okay? They're crazy. They're my friends when I was younger. Nuts. They used to try to kill each other. They were afraid to go fishing with each other because they didn't know who was going to come back. They decided to go camping one day. Okay, these two nut jobs go camping. All right? Now, Palohead's my brother. He was adopted. It's my gift. And what did you get me for Christmas? I got your brother. It was a good gift. Most people don't get that. They go camping and figure, fine. They're safe. They're going to get along. No, my father gets a call from, I think it was the Monticello police or whatever. We got them in jail. But what did they do? They chopped down our main tree that had all our flags on it. And they went to sleep in their tent right near the tree. So, yeah, my father had to pay for the tree. And they had to work it off at pretty much slave labor rates. We're getting the ass kicked every day. It was really funny. But that's what guys used to do, crazy stuff. Hey, you want a drag race? You want to bring out my Prius? We're going to go wild here. The guys have changed. You know what the average cause of death in young men used to be? Drag racing. You know what it is now? Prescription medication. Occult or sorcery, according to Jesus, for those of you who believe, comes from the word pharmakeias, which means making pills. Because he believed God can heal anything. I believe that too. If you want a prayer for me, they cost nothing. Ha ha! Thank you again. I'm not going to open this one up. But we're definitely... This is great. I really... I ask and you shall receive, and he is proof of that. I can't get into the answer. I can't get into the question. Well, I'm going to light a cigarette. Which, you know, at one time was normal. You know, I watch, you know, the old movies. I like them. The guy likes a cigarette. Nobody's jumping around going, you're killing me with secondhand smoke. No, it never happened. Don Mazzini, oh, you're smoking. Yeah, I'm gonna say you have smoke. Can you picture that if they put the smoking stuff in all the old movies? Just how silly guys would look? James Bond smoked. You see on a bomb, James Bond. Oh, you're smoking. I'm getting secondhand smoke. That's what men have become today. Think about it. Hey, Yakov, how you doing? I missed you. Hello, Gary. I have almost every audio you sell. Almost? Get them all. Just kidding. But I think sometimes it's too much information to take in one shot. Do you have any orders? Do you have any specific orders for listening to your amazing audios? There's no order. It's just like the martial arts. You can learn this block first or this block. They all have an application, and it's all a different application, and it's not too much information to take in, because it goes to your head. Sometimes you don't remember it, and when it has to happen, you apply it. Here's some great advice right now for guys, all of them, and it's free, but go hit up the site and buy some. Just doing this, okay? It looks stupid, but it gets your posture straight. The second biggest turn off, and I have it written down here, it's bad posture. There are guys who have posture so bad, they don't even need a woman in their life. I'm going to take a quick cigarette break here. Get your questions ready. Get to GaryBrodsky.com. Go buy something that's on sale. And here's some good music for you. That's crying. I think you should tell your dog what everybody already needs to know. And now you've had your drink. How did things get so far? I don't know. Never discuss the family business, ever. Remember an opportunity to act before you start screaming? Either way, I like him. He's great. Probably him right now. Oh yeah. You know. Chris, good evening. I just bought some MK17. I'm excited to try the shit out. Excellent show as always. And some great tunes. Thanks, Chris. All right. Thank you, Chris. It does work. If not, this is my deal. Pour it down the drain, give it to your friend as a gift. Take the bottle, do basketball practice with your garbage can, and we'll refund your money. We don't even want it back. Usually people have bought so much, and they're going to have to wait. The guys who are worried, well, what if you die and I can't get this anymore? They have 15, 20 bottles. One bottle is good for about a year. And that's pretty much it, and it does work. In fact, it works so well that people say, you know something, this is the big complaint I get. I can't wear this around my wife because it works too well. Oh, this is a very simple solution to that. Don't wear it around your wife. No, I never thought of that. It happens, I know. Because it's totally odorless, and it really is amazing. And I'm telling you, if it doesn't work, just send me an email. If it doesn't work, you will not be able to order anymore. Just because I got one guy who buys everything, charges back everything. And, you know, I don't care because I think he's funny. But don't imitate him, okay? Because I have enough of that. Now he can't buy MK17 anymore. He wants to actually repay everything because he's running out. Gary, how do I know I'm trying too hard when it comes to posture? Thanks. By the way, when is your workout video coming out? Well, it's right here. It's right here. It's just got to be uploaded and set into every format that you have. But it's right here, and it's really funny as well as informative, like most of my stuff. You got to add some humor. See, if you know the secret words, I'm going to send some of them here, the rest by the audio programs. What is the best secret word to get women? Baby. Yeah, as soon as the rock people figure that one out, everybody's a rock star. Before that, concert. If that, underwear flying on stage. Hey, baby, how you doing? Baby works. Women are looking for a guy to take care of them, not the other way around. A little, advice. Man, time is just rolling by. Questions, Gary Brodsky, 123 at AOL.com. Well, I find a good song here. Sorry, I can't find it. Well, we have, no, just kidding. I can't. What the hell happened to this? Just love this type of music. So blessing to everybody. Okay. Everybody feeling better? Yeah. All right. So, smoke in the eyes again. I hate that. But today, all the brainwashing. Kids don't really have fathers anymore. They have computers. Actually, this is a fact. Kids will spend way more time with their computer than with their father. That's it. Into the brainwashed world. And this is a serious fight. This is a serious war. And I plan to fight it to my death. And then come back and fight it again. You don't believe in reincarnation? I did in the past life. I don't know, Jason. I don't know why I'm laughing. Because I know this is going to be good. Why do unmen run when you start talking to them about getting laid with a woman? Thanks, Jason. They run. Now, that's I know Jason's concerned about people. Very. One of the best researchers in the world, this guy Jason, by the way. You know, he mentioned anything, he's done the research. There's two ways to look at it. One is a tragedy to society and the world. That's how Jason sees it. That's how I see it. The other way is, hey, there's a lot more women for me. Okay, that's pretty much, you got to straddle both beliefs or both facts. It's like, well, men aren't getting laid anymore. That's horrible. Society's falling apart. But as it's falling apart, I'm trying to fix it. There is so much more opportunity for me. Think about that one, too. It's a really, call it a two-edged sword. But guys are afraid of the reality because they've been programmed by computers and fantasies. And when it comes to reality, somebody's emotion, personality, character, they can't deal with that. They can't deal with the real thing. Come on, they got Facebook. What do you need women for? You got Facebook right there. All right, let's have some more questions. Gary Brodsky, 123 at AOL.com, or I'll music you to death. I'm not playing games there. All right, I'm trying to find a good song. I haven't, but anyway, I'll keep talking, because that's what I do. It's just really become to a point where I'm getting questions. Thanks, because I was going to go off on a tangent here, which I can do. Gary, what is the best way for someone who is shy, scared to just say, I want to sleep with you? So they really want to jump your bones? So what's the best solution? I'm going to tell it to you, but you probably won't like it. The solution is do it anyway, even though you're afraid. That's the difference between a coward and somebody who's a hero. A coward is afraid and a hero is afraid, believe me. But the hero does it anyway. And the whole fun of picking up women is that it is a bit scary. And that's the thrill. It used to be the thrill, now became the fear. So understand, it's part of the whole thing. And when you break through and say, hey, you look great, I'm taking you out, all of a sudden that fear is gone because you'll see, hey, this works. I remember the first time I fired a 44 Magnum. I saw people going flying with the kick, hammer stuck in their head. I said, this is scary. I'm never going to do this. And I was sort of stuck. And boom, the thing kicked like that. But after that, I wasn't afraid anymore because I knew what it felt like. And this is even less. It was a long time ago. And I actually was so afraid that I shot the thing that dried the thing out. But I overcame my fear. Are e-readers as bad as using tablets or computers? No, reading is important no matter how you do it. Technology will change. One time it would have been like stone tablets. Here, read these. You know, imagine borrowing that and I bring it back. You know, here's all this stone. And then, you know, it was carved on a wall. You want to read it? Come, yeah, it's on my wall. I carved it in there. Doesn't matter how you read, but reading makes the imagination think differently. It makes your subconscious mind wide open. Thank you, Gary. You're really building me up. Well, that's what I'm here for, believe it or not. The castration of the American male. This was written many years ago. It's amazing. This is written, people go, this is crazy. Now, it's like, boy, guys were pretty cool back then. What the hell happened? Just mention that. Oh, it's time for a cigarette. Smoking. Oh, my God, he's smoking. I know somebody out there is doing that. I know they're out there. Come on, text me up. Tell me how a bad influence all this other stuff. Well, I play a song. Anyone get texted tonight, they're going to get a song. A whole bunch of great songs for you, so that usually brings them down. But all the leaves are brown. Let's go. And the sky is gray. Have you noticed this? There are no new songs out there except for Taylor Swift. That's it, one song. Music was the third largest business in the world at one time. People don't want music anymore. I don't know what they want. They don't want women, they don't want music. Computer games are a science created to destroy people. And it's been very successful. The Dumbing Down of America, look it up. Charlotte Isby, it's a hard name to spell. Just look up Dumbing Down of America. And you will see just how dumbed down we really are. Gary, are people conditioned to smoke the way, same way that they are conditioned to be on their cell, on their crap phones? No, I conditioned myself. I started smoking at age 10. To look cool, it worked. What can I tell you? Been smoking for many years. My lung feels great. Okay, stupid joke there. But stupid jokes are good at times. But yeah, the important thing is, and it's on sexual science, right there on sale, $10, all right? Two sawbucks. Actually, two fins. A sawbuck is a 10. I grew up in a different economy. Sexual science on how to use your voice, how to make it work. Get it before it goes off sale. It's good to learn from ancients because they were wise and conquerors and built many great. That's absolutely true. The ancient people built cities that we can't even conceive of. Things we can't even build today with modern machinery. And they all had the occult backing them up. Every great empire, even the evil ones, the good ones, didn't matter. Use the occult. It's a tool. That's all it is. How you use it is up to you. Really. It's just like this. I use this for, you know, basically comedy on the show. I'm not going out mugging people with this. Wait for the comedy a little worse. Just kidding. But the occult is a tool. Occultsforce.com. Check it out. The stuff works there. Again, if it doesn't work, just let me know. I don't care. I will refund you money. Why? Because it works. And MK17 works. I wish I could demonstrate it, but I will be doing it in a bar that is hiring me to come in and show just how effective it is. Because the owner bar going, why do you have all the women around you? So, oh, it's a secret. I'm trying an experiment here. Come in here, do the secret, and promote my bar. I'll pay you to come in here. That's bad enough. I don't even drink. You don't have to. French fries and a hamburger. Yeah, you got me sold. I'm paid off. Cheap pay, but what the hell? And no, I will not know the night they're going to call me. because the whole thing is I cannot set it up. I will have 1 hour to get ready. And it's going to be fun. And it's going to be an audio program, a video program that will be for sale at GaryBrodsky.com and a few other new sites that will be opening up. Okay. This is going to be the last and final round for questions. So our last round for question songs and then the exit song. So get your questions in now, GaryBrodsky123@AOL.com, and I got to take off for the evening. So look at the license to be. Look at the license to have. Great comment here. Gary Jason again. Men nowadays are not men anymore. They don't race cars. They don't chase women. They don't do guy things. What the hell happened? It's called programming. To put you to sleep and make you feel safe in a fictitious world behind a computer screen. People, please wake the fuck up. Absolutely true. Thanks, Jason. What audio do I recommend for you personally? Anything. They all work. It's all on sale right now. All of it is just building your arsenal. Do you like freestyle music? Yes, I do. Okay. Last call for questions. And then I have... It's a new fanatics. All right. I got to just read this. It's a private. You are the king. You are the king, and I will definitely, you'll definitely be hearing from me. Thank you so much, everybody, for watching. Wednesday night, the Gary Brodsky Radio Show. And I got a great exit song here as soon as I can find it. It's okay, I got time. Okay, where is it? Come on! It's not wearing glasses. There's a Chinese menu there. Oh, I saw it for a second. Here it is. Okay, everybody. Good night. Thank you for watching. GaryBrodsky.com, ApocalypseForce.com, GaryBrodsky.com, ApocalypseForce.com, BrainTrain.com. Check it out. It's all there for you. Thank you. And good evening.